Have you guys ever wondered why pork is sometimes called a white meat? Or do you actually think pork is a white meat? Well, we're here to debunk that tonight, guys. I'm gonna show you why pork is indeed a red meat. We're gonna break down our pork chops. We're gonna compare them with some store-bought pork chops that I picked up tonight. And hopefully, by the end of this video, you guys see why going farm fresh and going local is the way to go. Good evening, guys, welcome back to the farm. Little bit of a different setting tonight. I understand that it's not every night that we get to sit here and talk food with you. It's certainly not a cooking channel by any means, but this is a large part of what we're doing here on the farm, producing high quality meats. So I thought it'd be fitting tonight to kind of share the differences between our pork and some store-bought pork. So I started this video off talking about pork being known as the other white meat. Well, that is really a thing. I personally think it's crazy, but that is a thing. And if you do think pork is a white meat, well, hopefully you learned something from me today. But that campaign originated in the 1980s. And I'm gonna say campaign because that's exactly what it was. It was from the pork industry, it was from Big Pork. And the reason that campaign started in the 1980s, low-fat diet became a big thing. Are you guys surprised our government telling us that fats are not good for us, right? So low fat diets became a thing. So unfortunately for pork, being that it is a red meat and a fatty meat, at the time the craze was low fat. So red meats were already considered bad. Fatty meats, of course, can't have them, right? So pork sales plummeted. The pork producers got together. Of course, they had to come up with something. So what did they do? They lobbied a bunch of money together, they campaigned, and they labeled pork as the other white meat. Does this sound familiar, guys? Okay, so moving on. Now that you know that pork being white was surely just a campaign, surely just propaganda, dare I say it, I also believe that store-bought pork is part of the reason we think pork is a white meat a lot of times. This cut here actually doesn't look too bad, but this is why I want to do a comparison tonight, because if you hold the two side by side, if I can get this in the camera, you clearly see a difference. Now, obviously mine's not packaged nearly as neatly. I leave a lot of fat on my cuts. I'm not a butcher by any stretch of the imagination, but as I unpackage these, I hope to show you the difference. I hope to be able to explain the importance of color as far as health of the product and as far as quality of the meat. And I'll also say it is really important, I'll touch on this here in a couple seconds, why looking at the color in the packaging, it will change, and I'll explain that here in a second. Okay guys, we got the chops out of the package. Let's take a look and compare them. So right here we got the store-bought chops, nicely cut. You can see the coloration, not too bad for store chops. You got our chops right here. Looks like a completely different cut of meat, a completely different product. Fat obviously is marbled in here, a nice dark red color. So what is it that causes a difference in color in the same pieces of meat? And does it matter? Is it even worth thinking about? Well, the short answer to that is it is the myoglobin that is in the muscle of your animal, and yes, it does matter. So as we break this down and as we talk about this, the redness in a piece of meat is surely the amount of myoglobin. We're gonna sound scientific, guys. I'm not by any stretch of the imagination, but this is the reality to it. This animal here had more myoglobin than this one. Simple as that. Now, what does that mean? It typically will mean that your animal was more active. When you have a more active animal, well, you're gonna have a healthier animal. Myoglobin is something, it's a protein that actually helps transport oxygen through the muscular structure of your animal. So as your animal is more active, you're gonna have more myoglobin, hence the red meat. To take it a step further, it actually binds iron which is obviously a lot of meat has iron, you know, a red type of meat, whether it's steak, whether it's pork, it's gonna have iron. That oxygen is gonna pass through the muscular structure and it's gonna oxidize. What does iron and oxygen do? Well, it forms rust, hence the dark red color of your meat. So really important that your animal and your meat has as much myoglobin as possible. When you cut open a steak or you cut open a pork chop, it is not blood. If you guys think it's blood that's pouring out of your steak when you cook it a little bit rare, no, that's simply myoglobin. That is the red colorness of your meat. That's very healthy. That is telling you that your animal was active and it lived a healthy life. Conversely speaking, when you look at a cut like this pork chop here, and I got a strand hanging, but when you look at a pork chop like this one, very pale, not a whole lot going on. That is because this animal, you guys know how this was raised, didn't have a lot of space to roam. It wasn't foraging. It wasn't rooting like I've shown several times on our channel. It's pretty much penned up, guys, and it's not moving a whole heck of a lot. With that, the muscle doesn't get worked. So you're only gonna have fat here on the outer cap versus our chop, where sometimes you can't even tell that these are chops because there's so much fat kind of marbled in there. But our animals are constantly moving. They're constantly rooting and using those muscles. So again, myoglobin running through that tissue, creating that oxidation effect. And the studies do show it. I'm not just making this stuff up. Animals that are active have 3 to 5 more times amount of myoglobin than those that aren't. And I think it shows here today, guys. Take a look at it again. There's definitely a difference in the meat. And I almost forgot one more thing, why I said leaving them in the package at the time was important. As you take meat out of packaging, it actually will darken up as it is exposed to oxygen. I'm not gonna try to say that word again. But if you've ever wondered why your vacuum sealed meat looks a little pale, that's why. There's a lack of oxygen there, so that myoglobin is not responding to oxygen, creating, again, that red color. But as soon as you pull it out, it typically will redden up. Even the store-bought meat has brightened up here a little bit. So just another little fun fact for you. So when you really think about it, it comes down to, is your animal active or is it not? It's really that simple. I know I threw some fancy scientific terms out there for you, which, quite honestly, guys, I'm learning myself. I like to read as much as I can. I think that is my responsibility, being a farmer and trying to produce the highest quality food that we can here on the farm. So I have to kind of know this stuff a little bit. But it really comes down to how active is your animal. Just think about it. Put it simple. If your animal's out there foraging, it's going to get hundreds, if not thousands, of micronutrients that an animal in a factory type setting just isn't going to get. It's not gonna have the availability to nutrients. It's gonna be pumped full of the same old commercial feed, where our animals, again, are just, they have the luxury of just living a happy life, stress-free. That's another big part of raising livestock, keeping them as stress-free as possible. Animals under stress, again, they're just not going to have the same quality. They're not gonna work their muscles the same. They're gonna be tensed up. The tenderness is not gonna be there. This stuff, when I cook it, and I'm not gonna go in and do the same comparison that everyone else does. I'm not gonna cook it for you and take a bite and pretend how great it is compared to the store-bought pork. It is. I'll tell you right now, this is better stuff, but the tenderness is gonna be there. This fat, I mean, it just melts in your mouth, where you guys have all had pork chops, you know that, you know, it's most of the time it's pretty tough. So that's where we're at. Now, what can you do about it? I'm not here to belittle anyone buying store-bought pork. That's not the purpose of this channel. That's not the purpose of this video. Buy what you can afford, eat what you can afford, obviously. But I will also say health is not something that, you know, I necessarily would put a price tag on. We always talk about this here in our house as far as health is something that you just find a way to afford. Quality food is something you just do and you sacrifice in other areas. Obviously, medical expenses are high. So where's your trade-off there? Are you gonna eat healthy now and live a flourishing life? or are you going to buy garbage because it's cheap and then potentially pay the price down the road? So my recommendation, look in if you can't produce your own pork, and I understand most people watching this video probably can't. You know, obviously it takes a little bit of land, it takes infrastructure. If you can, great. Jump on it right now. We got tons of other videos to kind of point you in that direction. But if you can't, look local. If you don't think you can find somebody local, please reach out to me, give me your roundabout location, and I will find a place for you. I can promise you that there's somebody within driving distance that you can get locally raised, high quality pork from. So anyway, guys, I hope you found that one interesting. We had a lot of fun with it. Again, it is my responsibility, somebody producing our own food here on our farm. I think it's really important that you kind of understand what makes up high quality food, how to distinguish, you know, is your food truly a little bit higher quality than that of the commercially produced stuff? And I thought comparing the two, again, you can see a difference. Comparing the two, I thought would be a good way to kind of show it to you guys and help you understand as well. So again, hope you found this one interesting. We really appreciate you tuning in today. If you like what we're doing, as always, you can give us a thumbs up, like this video, hit the subscribe button. We really appreciate that to continue following along on our journey. You can also support the channel by checking out a few links below. We'll definitely put them in for you. We're cooking tonight, so I will be sure to put in some Wagyu beef tallow that we'll cook these up with, because right after this, we're gonna have some pork chops. And yes, I will eat these too. It's meat, not here to say meat's not good for you, so we're gonna eat them as well. But check out the links below. We appreciate your support there. And as always, guys, thank you for watching. Have a great night.